No matter what kind of work you're in, there are good days and bad days, but we all know some jobs are downright tough.
That's especially true for the men and women in Texas who investigate cases of child abuse with Child Protective Services. In the last few months, we have shown the problem of investigators burning out and quitting at alarming rates.
But as KXAN investigator Robert Maxwell explains, there seems to be a change which could see more children protected. And there's a tool aimed at boosting morale that could also recruit new caseworkers.
Even before the death of 2-year-old Colton Turner last summer put the spotlight on how CPS investigators failed him, many were already leaving the agency in droves. Stressful working conditions or lack of support drove up the turnover rate to 58%. A concerted effort then got underway to stem that tide. It includes mentoring for new hires, retraining managers, and
I really do feel like I'm a change maker when I'm out there.
A new video featuring CPS staff highlighting their positive experiences.
I feel like everything that we do makes a difference.
Knowing that we made a difference is such a sense of relief.
The video's creator is also the agency's communications director.
Well, after we showed it to our workers, we realized it was just too inspiring to just put on a shelf.
Some critics might say this video is just window dressing.
Well, it's not window dressing, it's people speaking from their heart.
It makes me feel amazing when I can actually help somebody and provide them a future.
So with sentiments like that echoing around CPS, could the so-called transformation effort now be starting to bear fruit? There are 296 investigator positions in Region 7, which takes in Travis, Williamson, and Hayes counties. Last June, KXAN found CPS investigator vacancies topped 19.5%. Flash forward 5 months later to October, and the vacancy rate was down to 12.8%.
It's not a job for just anybody, but for those people who it's really the right job, it's the best job.
At the end of the day, there's one question you have to ask yourself. Are the children safe?
I'm very proud to work for CPS.
And the very latest numbers on this, as of early December, vacancies among CPS investigator positions in our area are down to about 10.8%. Robert Chen.
So Robert, how does that compare to other CPS employees who don't have direct contact with these abuse cases?
Right, because the caseworkers have a lot of stress in their jobs, right. It's assumed, right? Actually, it's within a point or two now. So the implication is there's a more of a balance that they're even staying in their jobs a little longer. Of course, we'll keep you updated on all this.
All right, Robert, thank you very much. Of course, this is an issue we have been following for months, and you can see our full series of reports right now in the Investigates section of KXAN.com.